back with our fifth segment of Masters 2016 on KRFOradio.com. And before we get back into golf, which is what I want to finish with, we have yet to touch on the Twins, Phil. They are 0-5 as we're recording this, playing here their getaway day in Kansas City. Last year they started 1-7. They ended up with what I thought was a very good season, and I really do have a lot of faith in Paul Molitor. I think he's a great baseball guy. I think he's surrounded by a very good coaching staff. I couldn't say that before when you had Gardenhire and Rick Anderson and, you know, some of the guys on that staff. But these starts, we joke about it, how it's such a long season, and it, you know, it's not anything to worry about. But you know, if they started 7-1 last year instead of 1-7, they probably would have made the playoffs as a wild card. And they're 0-5. You know, it's, the games have been close, but they're not hitting yet. And I'm just not sure with this pitching, you know, that they're really going to ever be in it this year. To be honest, I just don't think the pitching's good enough.
Do you think the expectations that kind of have built, you know, well, they put them on themselves a little bit too, but that the fans have now put on this team, you know, based on some of the guys, like, I mean, you know, Lavelle basically has been, you know, hyping these guys in the minor league system, Buxton, Sano, Rosario to a certain extent, and now that they're all here, and last year they had some success with that, with kind of these newer Twins, I guess. I just don't know if it's fair to think that, well, now we won whatever it was, 86 games last year.
How many did we? I think it's less than that, but all right, well, I'll go
okay.
with that.
I don't know.
Around the 85 number.
Sure. So to say, well, now we're going to win 90 games, or now we're going to win 95, and we're going to, you know, I mean, first of all, we have a tough division. Second of all, I just don't think it's, you know, the expectations are, you know, I'm not saying I want to be the team that's going to be good someday forever, but I just don't think we're there now.
Yeah, I mean, I expect that the lineup is going to hit, and I'm okay with waiting for that and, you know, waiting to see when that's going to finally click. Sano's off to a slow start. Buxton's off to a slow start. Trevor Plouffe's off to a slow start. Brian Dozier's off to a slow start.
The one guy who's not off to a slow start
is Joe Mauer. He's done it. He's 2-for-2 today. And, you know, scoreless game with Kansas City. But, yeah, he's done okay. And my guy, my favorite Twin right now is Eduardo Escobar. And all that little guy does is hit. And, you know, he's got 5 doubles already on the year as a shortstop, you know, yep. Who's, you know, you talk about American League shortstops, and Eduardo Escobar would be about the 14th name you'd bring up.
And we wouldn't have thought, I mean, even the beginning of last year, Santana was still going to be the guy.
Right. So I guess, and now he looks like he could be headed to the DL. He had to be taken out of yesterday's game. He was in center field playing for Buxton and came up with some kind of a pulled hamstring or something. They were 83-79 last year. So
wins,
yeah,
you know.
It's. But again, I mean, they're at that point where they're above 500 for the first time since 2010. So it was a step forward for sure. And I do think that they're in the right direction. I don't think that their bullpen, you know, unless we see some stuff, is set up to shut teams down. I mean, that's the way you win these
Jepson's
days. Jepson's had a rough start. Trevor Mays looked good. Casey Fien looks like he could be designated for assignment any day now. He's had 2 real clunkers. You know, Glenn Perkins hasn't even had a chance to see if he's bounced back from what was a horrible second half of last year. So we'll wait and see there, but the starters, you know, it's early.
What do you take from I didn't really follow their spring training progress. A, how did they play down there? And B, how much weight do you put on what they do in the spring and whether that transfers over to, you know, within the first couple months of the season?
Yeah, the spring's meaningless. To me, mostly what the spring is about is to get the hitters ready to hit. And I think, you know, but that's the thing. Sano was on fire in the spring. We haven't seen it yet. Same thing with Buxton, had a very good spring, and we haven't seen that translate yet. You know, so I don't know. I mean, it's hard to tell. The pitching in the spring is you learn nothing. You know, they're 3-4 mile an hour slower than they are in the regular season. The starters don't ever really have a real start than they would in the regular season. So, you know, we'll just have to wait and see. But I'll tell you what, 0-5. If they don't win this game today, you know, you're 0-6 going into opening day at Target Field tomorrow. It's
kind of a lot of pressure to put on a team going up against World Series champs if they don't win this today.
Hey, it's no good. It's the old thing where, you know, you can't – you can't win a pennant in April, but you can lose one, and they're on their way to losing one right now if they don't win a few games.
Yeah, we always seem to start out in a hole. We did the same thing last year. You mentioned the 1-7 start, but then we just caught fire.
Mm-hmm.
We led the Central for a couple of weeks into May, into the end of the May.
So. Well, you know, I am going to cross my fingers and just kind of hope that what's happened here is an anomaly. Like I said, they did start 1-7 last year, and that was a really ugly 1-7. If you remember those games, they were getting smoked. You know, at least now they're in some of these games, except for last night. But, you know, it gets to the point where, I mean, Ricky Nolasco is the starter today. Maybe he will shut down Kansas City and surprise us, but these other starters really kind of done nothing yet, and the offense has not given them any help either. I can't blame it on the starters. I should take that back. I'll give them 3 starts before I start to, you know, make some conclusions there. But, you know, the offense is got to get better. And I'll be honest, like Trevor Plouffe, I'm not sold on him. They've invested in him, and they've said he's our guy. Not sold on him at all. I think, you know, if I look at that lineup, I think Sano is going to be a star.
Probably not in right field, though.
Well, yeah, it's been an adventure out there, but just he's no problem there. Maurer, no problem there. Dozier, no problem there. Catching situation is up in the air. Rosario, you know, hopefully he's a young guy, but hopefully he comes along. I do like Eduardo Escobar, but it's not, you know, it's not an imposing lineup. It's certainly not the 27 Yankees.
No, I don't think anybody's going to confuse anything the Twins have done with the 27 Yankees. I will say this, I'm excited for opening day at Target Field tomorrow.
Okay.
I haven't fully decided if I'm going to try and sneak in there at all or not. We'll see how the work.
3 o'clock start?
3 o'clock start, so it's really kind of, you know, you really only have to, like, pretend not to work for a couple hours.
Yeah. Well, when you're like you and you live nearby, you can sneak out.
Yeah, so I'll look into that. I haven't seen the weather forecast, but that's one thing that I really like about, and I know it's kind of, you know, it's been around for 4 years now, or 5 years, I guess. But going to a game out there at Target Field, you know, yeah, you want to see them compete, and it's not fun to see us lose, but there was a couple of Saturdays and Sundays we went there to the park last year. It's just what a big, you know, in a great city that's got a beautiful ballpark, and now we're going to have, you know, the other bank on the east side. But I'd like to see him turn around. Now, 0-5, are you again? You said you can lose it, you can't win it. But if they're 5-0, are you on the other side? Well, here we go. This is it. This is what we expected.
You feel better though. You know, the thing is. Now you got to do, like you said, you got to go on some of these runs. You know, can you reel off 8 out of 10? And things, that's tough to do in baseball. You know? When the Twins won the World Series in 91, they had that 15-game winning streak in June. It was incredible. When they made the playoffs in 06, they had an unbelievable stretch in the month of June where they won like 28 out of 30 or some weird thing. You know, but you just can't count on stuff like that.
Didn't they, in 2000, didn't they win 20 in a row or something like that in May? May?
2000? I don't think
so. Yeah, that was like the Get to Know 'em campaign.
Yeah, there was no 20 in a row involved in it, though.
19, no?
No, no. 15 in a row is they haven't done that since 91 when they did that.
Okay.
Yeah, it's, you know, they've had some runs, and it's not, I'm not saying that, like I said, it's, we can't say 5 games through that, you know, the season's over or anything like that, but it's concerning. It's to the point where,
who's the leader of this team?
That's a great point. That is my point, actually, is, you know, I mean, Torrey Hunter's gone. I don't know that they have that guy. You know, I mean, there's a certain amount. Bernie's going to get a double here. That's too bad. I think that's the last we can talk about Bernhard Langer. I think it's over.
CBS has given him his
due. Yeah,
today,
they've given him his due by showing the first 3 holes, and I don't think you're going to see him again. I don't know that they have a leader. We are back one more segment here on our Masters podcast. Thanks for hanging with us.